don't know, it was real, it was just real pretty, and then like all the colors were defined. I like really like 4K, like nice pixelated pictures.
That was like risking her own life. But either way, I still think this is very powerful because she stood up to, for what she believed in, and that's saving her son.
The picture I chose was a picture we used for our college tour last week. The tour was a tour of Morehouse College. The reason I chose this picture is simply because it challenges the stereotypes of African American males in the United States.
Because it means a lot to me.
Why?
Because us black humans, I mean, for me, I feel like that it means that we come as one, we stand as one, no matter what.
So, I don't know if you guys have seen the movie Selma. Have you guys seen that movie?
Yes.
Okay, so. Definitely. So in Selma, the reason why the Selma march was so powerful was because Martin Luther King did the nonviolent march in order to bring peace and to have voting rights for black people in that environment. So what was going on in Selma was that black people didn't really have the right to vote. So Martin Luther King, what he was able to do was he was able to use the media. He was able to use the media to kind of manipulate everyone around that surrounding area to see what was going on and to understand that, look, we don't have equal rights here in this country, and we're gonna keep going to go try to go to the polls. We're gonna take a multitude of black people at one time to these polls where they're not letting us vote, and we're gonna say we have the right to vote. And so they would nonviolently go up to the courthouses. They would stand up there. The people would have peaceful protests, just taking up space. And, you know, certain crowds of people, Europeans, didn't like that. So they would retaliate in a negative way. And, of course, you know, you have people that sacrificed, you know, their life to do peaceful protesting, knowing that there was people that hated them, trying to kill them. But, you know, fortunately, the president was able to get involved because of Martin Luther King and because these events made it to the media. So once that happened, there has to be a change, because now once something is out there to the public, like once people are hearing that a grandma's getting beat by a police officer, or a black boy's getting beat by a police dog, like he said, or when they see that people are dying out here on the streets just because they're trying to vote, it's like
same thing Martin Luther King did, but in our own way. You get what I'm saying? So the limitations, there are none when it comes to being able to get your message or that positive narrative that you want to say. You want to teach people a new way of thinking, give them a tool, and then they'll be able to create whatever they want. That's basically what they say. And then our favorite one, the pen is mightier than a sword, or the camera can be more lethal than both. All right, so everybody always talks about, you know, the power of an image being 1,000 words. Literally, you can create a million words by creating a video.